In this video, we're going to look at how you can receive tips and donations in your YouTube live stream without having SuperChat enabled. Stick around. G'day, this is Doug from Doug Hewson YouTube, and we're here to help you with tech wherever possible. Today, we're continuing a series we're doing on live streams and YouTube live streams in particular, and we're talking about the topic of getting donations and tips during your live stream without SuperChat. As you know, SuperChat is available to all those who are in the YouTube partner program, more than 1,000 subs, and people can leave tips and comments on your live stream. Well, there's a number of services that are available for collecting tips and donations where you don't even need to have SuperChat enabled. You could even use it as an alternative to SuperChat or in addition to SuperChat. So why would this be useful? Let's have a look at a couple of points of why being able to collect donations and tips could be useful to you for your YouTube live stream. Number one, you're not yet in the YouTube partner program. Because if you're not in the partner program, you can't have SuperChat enabled. Number two, you're a streamer or a lot of your viewers are in a country where SuperChat is just not available. So this is an alternative for those who just aren't able to do SuperChat for whatever reason, because of geolocation or because they don't have a credit card. Which takes us to point three. They are alternative methods of giving. With SuperChat, you can only give with a credit card. But with some of these other methods, you have other giving methods available like PayPal and even via SMS or text. All the services we mentioned today are solid options, and at the end of the video, I'm going to mention which one I recommend. So make sure you stick around for that. One other thing to note with all the services mentioned is not only are they taking the donations and tips, but they're also linked in with software that includes on-screen alerts and other overlay abilities during your live stream with the tipping and donation service mentioned. All the details will be in the description below. The free services that were closed but no cigar for me today were the following. The first one was StreamJar. The reason why I declined StreamJar, there was no YouTube integration. Next one is Lutz. Lutz is an invitation-only service at the moment, so there's limitations on accessing that service, so it's wiped out right away. And the last one, StreamElements. StreamElements YouTube integration is in beta, so it's not a fully baked product yet, in my mind. So we'll cover those at a later time when they become more fully featured. But anyway, let's head on over to the computer and let's look at the four options that I've come up with you for today. Now we're here on the computer and we're looking at the first of the four we're going to look at today, and this one is Streamlabs. So here we are, let's look at the screen here. When you first log in, you get the option to log in with various accounts including Twitch, YouTube, Mixer, Facebook. So depending on which account you're streaming with, in this case we're talking about YouTube, so I'm going to quickly log into my YouTube account by clicking on log into YouTube. It'll ask you to access your Google account, which is part of the process, so that's fine. Just click allow. That's just so it can pick up things for some of the other features that Streamlabs have. So when you come into Streamlabs, you get this screen that we're looking at now, which is basically the dashboard. What you want to go down to is donation settings and set that up, in addition to setting up your account settings. This one over here, which is donation settings, and you want to tell it how you want to collect donations, which in Streamlabs is PayPal, which is probably the primary one, credit cards, and then some obscure ones like UnitPayRU, which I think is Russian, and Skrill. As you can see, it's connected to my PayPal account here. And then if you click on the settings tab up here, you can set some of the basic elements of your landing page. It's just the page where people can go to. When they click on the link on your stream, it takes them to the donation page. So that's what we're looking at here. Now I've got my settings set up for my currency. There's a whole bunch of currencies, but of course I got mine set up for Australian dollars because I'm in Australia. The donation page currency detects automatically. I just leave that as that. Minimum, maximum amounts. Like what's the minimum amount? Like I've got it set for, the minimum is a dollar. Sorry, the maximum is maximum message length. With YouTube, the maximum comment length is 200. So you don't want it set for over 200. So I'm going to set mine for 200. Login required. Donors required to log in for donations. This helps fight fraud and chargebacks. It's recommended to leave that on so you don't get anything dodgy happening in regards to people trying to reverse the PayPal or credit card or whatever method that you're going with. They recommend to leave that on, so I've left that on. They also have here a suggested amount, which is, I've set mine for $1 just to match my lowest amount, because you don't want to pressure someone into picking a specific amount. I think it's better just to let people give what they want to give when it comes to a live stream. Preferred lingo is, do you want to call it a donation, a tip, or something custom? I've got mine set for tip. You can change the donation or you can make it whatever you want. Here it tells you what your link is that you can put in your description for people to direct people to that donation page. You can put that URL in your description so people can click on that to donate. And then there's some options about the color of the button, some donation memo, which is maybe a little message you want to put there. And here you can upload a banner, and there's some profanity filters just for people when they leave a message, that it's automatically filtering that out, because quite often in the stream, you might be overlaying that in your stream, the words with the comment, and then it goes up. If there's profanity on there, you've got no recourse of taking that off. It's gone out to the masses. And so if you make any changes, click save settings. Obviously, when you do it the first time, you want to save the settings. It's saving the settings there. We're going to go up to that landing page that we saw. There's a link there, so I'm just going to click on it here. And then here it says tip money. It's already plugged in my name. So if you're logged in, it's going to try and plug your name in, but I can say my name is George, and I'm going to tip $10. And then down here, they can put a message. And then once they've filled those bits in, they click tip, and then it gives you a summary. I'm giving AUD $10, payment method. And then I've clicked PayPal because it's the only option available. They can, if you had the other options, if your credit cards turn on that, you can click that. And they go click submit tip. It'll take them to the usual PayPal page where they log in and confirm the payment, basically. But we're not going to do that now. We'll go back to Streamlabs. In Streamlabs, there's something called My Donations, which gives you the summary of all the donations that you've received, date and time, so you can go back and see what that's all about. And you can export it to a CSV if you want to have a look at some reporting in regards to that. It might be useful if you need to do tax and stuff at the end of your financial year, that sort of thing. You can have a look, and it will give you a list of top donors for the month, and you can run through those. There's something called banned donors, banning someone from actually donating for whatever reason, maybe somebody who repeatedly does chargebacks or something like that. Up on the dashboard, it gives you some interesting stats. You can look at this on an hour-by-hour basis for stuff that you might want to look at in regards to donations, and then some of the other features of Streamlabs, which we're not looking at in this video, but things like alerts and overlays, subscriber alerts and super chats and different things like that. There's what's called a bunch of widgets down here, like alert box and goals and event list, which is how you actually get everything to display on your stream. And that's a whole other video, which we're going to look at a little bit later. And so make sure to subscribe to the channel so that you can get that when that comes out at a later date. So that's Streamlabs. Donating, probably PayPal, credit card, and some other third-party payment platforms. Okay, the next one's called StreamTip. Now, StreamTip is associated and linked with the Nightbot auto moderator website. So it can do some moderation type things on your chat as well. We're looking at the stream tip part of this. Again, you gotta log in, give it permission to do its thing. And in a few seconds, the screen will update and we will see a little dashboard area. This is the stream tip dashboard. And this is a lot similar to Streamlabs in its setup. So you can go to the tip page here, which shows us where the tips come in with a little graph. To get to the place where you set up the tip page, up here where the admin thing is, pull that down. It's got your name there. Just click on account. This will take to a number of pages with tabs, which is to do with setting up the account. The first page here is the payments page, which is a bit like what we saw on the Streamlabs here. We can set our currency, which I've set for AUD, minimum and maximum we'll accept. Maximum is set for zero here in this case because we have no limit. So we're not putting a limit on them. And then there's some information on how you want to receive. And in this case, you can receive donations by Bitcoin or PayPal. Now, of course, like last time, I've got PayPal set up, But if you've got some sort of Bitcoin, you can log in. If you've got Coinbase, I don't know much about Bitcoin, but if you're into Bitcoin, you'll know exactly what's going on there. So you can plug in your PayPal details, link up your Coinbase account, and then click update settings, and that gives me the really basic payment details. Now, what I can also do is go to the tab that says tipping page, and this is where you get to format the look and feel of your tipping page. I've uploaded a banner, as you can see here. I can remove the banner if I want. I can set the background color here. You can put like a description like we saw on the first one. There's a profanity filter here, which you can add, which is similar. We can put in filtered words. We can actually plug in the specific words we want to filter. I haven't got that filled out at the moment. Count newness. Now, if we go to the tip page, I'm just going to go to the link. If you want the link to the tip page, over here, it says account tipping page user info, it says tipping page, click here. The easiest way to get that is just to open it up and copy and paste the URL from the bar and put that in your description. It's got my blurb that I customized on the left-hand side here. I can choose to be anonymous or not. They can put their amount in and select whichever amount they want, whichever currency they want to give. Leave a message, and then once they're done, click tip with PayPal, go through the PayPal process like we saw with the StreamLabs account. The way that the stream tips shows up in your stream, it doesn't actually show up as overlay, although you could. Because it's integrated with Nightbot, Nightbot can, if you've got Nightbot activated, put the tip in your chat to appear like a super chat, just minus the super chat colors. So it'll say it's from Nightbot, and it will announce that they've donated the amount and the username. So it's like an announcement in the chat. You can go that way, or you can actually go and have it as an overlay as well. Now we're going to look at the next one. Yeah, you have to be careful not to get TippyStream confused with its other website. This one will be basically in a similar vein to what we've looked at already. So first of all, we're going to need to connect with our YouTube account. Now, this one's a little bit more graphical in its display. It can do all the overlay things like we were talking about with StreamLabs. So let's go look at, I think I need to go to settings. Ah, here we go, payment methods. So yeah, we can activate different payment methods. At the moment, I've activated PayPal on here. Let's go to the donation page here. For me, this interface is a little bit more clunky. There's a lot more sliders, there's a lot more graphical. And I can choose to call it a donation or a tip. Here I can upload an avatar. We can adjust the colors of our text and our background. There's also a profanity filter for the messaging. Back up here, of course, is the minimum donation amount, a suggested donation, and the maximum message length. So very similar again to some of the ones we've already looked at. So let's look at the landing page. I don't think I've set this up with a banner or anything. So at the moment, it's just using like a default background, which I think is what they do. It uses your avatar there. So it's got Doug Hewson YouTube. There's my avatar there. The amount I want to give, you can put a message and your email address and then go to the PayPal process as normal. This last one, again, as you can tell by this splash page, is very bright and colorful. But let's look at their payment methods and setting up. Again, so let's go and connect with YouTube, with all Google. So now I'm in directly into the donation page portion. And we can turn on payment options like PayPal, Fortumo. Now Fortumo is people who are giving based on a text message. You can go into your PayPal and configure that to the currency, put your PayPal email in, default currency, minimum value, and then click save. The only issue I have with Keep Me Live at the moment is it's a little bit buggy on the website, so it could be an issue. Have a look at the landing page. This is certainly buggy, a bit like the other one. I've got our avatar, it's got my background there, so that's pretty cool. You can go name, so we've got George. I can put a message. Read terms and conditions, and I can, now, funnily enough, this one doesn't ask for the amount up front, and asks for PayPal or pay with mobile. Now I want to see what this does because I haven't checked this out. But I went with the pay by mobile option, so then it's gonna ask me to buy credits. So that's a little bit odd. I'm not sure how that all works. If I go PayPal option, then it gives me, I can pick the amount and the currency I want to give, and then click donate, and then it's gonna take me to PayPal to process. Keep Me Live a bit buggy, but if you can get it to work, it could be potential if you want to receive donations by SMS rather than the standard PayPal or bank accounts. Keep Me Live, out of the four that I've listed today, that's at the bottom of my four. Out of the four that I've just covered, the one I'm going with is StreamLabs. Streamlabs ticks all the boxes for payment methods and integration into your live stream. This video is part of the live streaming on YouTube video series. You can watch the entire playlist by clicking on the card right above right now. Make sure to subscribe below and check out this video that YouTube thought you might like. This is Doug from Doug Hewson YouTube, and I'm out.